Today's video is about alternatives to rice. Hello, welcome to video number 2 of Allergy Awareness Week. This week I'll be uploading one video every day to commemorate this special occasion. I appreciate that this is a little bit of a niche subject, but I cannot be the only one out there allergic to rice, and there are many reasons why you might want to swap rice out for something else. I am allergic to rice. I can eat gluten, carbs, starches, sugars, all of that jazz. Just rice will mess me up, and quinoa, but we'll get onto that. While I've researched this as much as I possibly can, only you know your body and what you can tolerate. I do mention low FODMAP a bit. Some of it's not quite low FODMAP, but I know a lot of FODMAPers that can tolerate it in small amounts. Please don't take my word for it if you know that you can't. You know, just be cautious. This video exists just to give you some ideas rather than advice. I just want to tell you what I swap rice for, basically. So if you want to cook for me, you won't kill me. So the first one is pasta. Pasta in general is absolutely magic. You can just throw it in any dish. It doesn't really matter what shape sometimes, so it can go in salads, it can go in soups, it can go alongside a curry, that's quite nice sometimes. It's very versatile, and if you can eat rice, there are many gluten-free, low FODMAP, low carb alternatives to pasta. There's so many things you can do with it. So if you can't eat wheat pasta, you can eat another type of pasta, and it just works. The second one is still technically a pasta. It's orzo. So if you don't know what orzo is, it's like a rice-shaped pasta. You could probably substitute it anywhere, but I found that it goes really well in soups. It goes really well in salad. I once made a rice-free paella. It was not good, but it wasn't the orzo's fault. There are gluten-free options available. I'm not sure how available the gluten-free version is in the UK, because I don't eat it, but it does exist in the world. My third one is technically pasta again. Couscous. It's small grains of pasta. It's got similar uses to orzo. You can put it in soups, you can put it in salads, I use it to stuff peppers with, that's quite nice, or it goes next to stuffed peppers when I stuff the peppers with something else. And it's also really good just on its own. It carries flavour really well. It's very, very quick to make. I have been told that there are gluten-free versions. Again, they contain rice, so I haven't tried them. Substitute number 4, noodles. You can make noodles out of anything. You've got like egg noodles, whole wheat noodles, you can spiralize a zucchini or courgette, depending where you're from. Butternut squash, I've seen butternut squash noodles, they're quite interesting. They can also make a really good alternative to spaghetti. I've seen courgette noodles be used as spaghetti for a bolognese. It was an interesting experience, but it's an option. Substitute number 5, chips. It's quite a British one there. Don't judge me on this. Sometimes instead of, like, if the rice is to go with something, so like when you have a curry and then you have the rice and then you mix it, I will put chips in there. So curry and chips, that's not uncommon in the UK. Chili, that also works. Anytime that you might have rice on the side, just whack some chips in. You can also make it a lower carb option by using sweet potato fries, sweet potato chips. Very versatile, and you can make them thin, you can make them thick, you can do whatever you want with it. I have actually heard somebody make a sweet potato rice. I have no idea how they did it and whether it was any good or how it would work, but it looked good in the pictures, so maybe give that one a go. Number six, quinoa. I am very allergic to quinoa, so I have never tried this, but the amount of people that have recommended that I try quinoa tells me that it's a very good alternative. It's low FODMAP, it's low carb, it's gluten-free. It goes really well in salads. I see it in salads a lot. Very prominent in like vegan cooking. Basically anything cold, it would probably go with that. I've seen it done hot as well. But again, I have never tried it. I've just heard really good things about it. Number 7, cauliflower rice. This one is incredible. This one changed my life, I swear. You can buy it pre-packaged. You can also just buy a cauliflower and chop it up, but that does take a while. You can put it in a food processor. According to the app that I use on my phone, it is not low FODMAP, but it's only a little bit FODMAP. I know a lot of FODMAPers that can tolerate it in small or medium amounts. Occasionally, as long as they're not overdoing it, they can can manage that. If you know that any deviation from low FODMAP is going to mess you up, maybe don't try this one. It's also low carb, gluten free, very versatile, you can do anything with it. I just like to stir fry it with some soy sauce. Substitute number 8, broccoli rice. Similar to cauliflower rice, apart from it is low FODMAP, low carb, gluten free. I don't know how available it is, I've never actually seen it in a shop, but then if you are able to chop it up, you could chop that up. You could also put it in a food processor, but I think it might go a bit smaller than the cauliflower. You can just use it exactly like cauliflower rice, and it's excellent if you want to get a few more greens in your diet, and all the folic acid that comes with that. Subject number 9, pearl barley. I don't use pearl barley that much because it's not the easiest. It's not difficult to cook with, you can just throw it in a pot. But as I have hinted at, depression rules my cooking. So all of my food is a depression meal. I don't cook anything that would be cooked long enough to cook the pearl barley. But it's very good. I have had it in a variety of soups, so I know it's in a lot of tin soup, so vegetable soup. It's incredible in vegetable soup. And anything that's got like a stew, anything that's like hearty, that like would have rice in it, you can pop it in there. Number 10, buckwheat. It's low FODMAP and it's gluten-free. It's quite high carbs. I never use it, but I've heard a lot of good things, so I might have to give it a try. You can put it in salads, you can make hot things with it. You can buy buckwheat flour and you can use that in like savoury baking, and you can use it in pancakes. I've even seen a couple of recipes for porridge. Number 11, bulgur wheat. Basically it's similar to couscous. Anywhere that you'd put couscous in, you could put bulgur wheat. It's not low FODMAP, it's not gluten free, and it's not low carb. So this is, I guess, for people like me who aren't following a specific sort of medical diet, just avoiding your allergens. And the last one, number 12, is polenta. Now, I've never used polenta either. I should probably start, or maybe give it a go. Been told it's similar to mashed potatoes. I'm not really sure where I would substitute it in for rice, but it is low FODMAP, low carb, and gluten-free. So I just think it deserves an honourable mention. Don't forget to like this video, drop a comment in, and subscribe. Ring the bell to get notified whenever I post a new video. Don't forget to stay tuned for this series. There are 5 videos left every day this week to commemorate Allergy Awareness Week.